Hello and welcome. While corrupt mainstream media studiously ignores it, alternate news sources often quote Henry Kissinger's notorious insult, deriding all military men as dumb, stupid animals. Now, the veracity of this comment may be open to debate, but the question of intellectual acuity arises when the colossal body of evidence exposing the methods of deliberately engineered and calculatingly provoked geopolitical conflict is indisputable. It's common knowledge that a small group of Luciferian, socio-psychopathic banksters contrive endless wars for financial and geopolitical gain, yet astonishingly, in the full glare of this incontestable expose, mindless volunteers continue to line up to have body, mind, and soul damaged beyond repair, willingly becoming cannon fodder for the self-indulgence of the worst criminals in human history, beggars belief. Even more so since it's now proven that the architects of war fund and supply both sides of every conflict. Nothing can be so dumb and stupid as to self-sacrifice in such a foolhardy manner, thereby giving justification to Kissinger's sneer. In the past, common folk had little or no choice regarding military service, but today's information availability provides forensic situation analysis and fully informed decision-making. Even the most casual investigation exposes war as a monstrously evil racket, an inescapable fact clearly evidenced by countless books, hard-hitting documentaries, first-hand accounts, all underscored by the damning testimony of countless whistleblowers. Not a single war throughout all of history was ever unleashed for the reasons publicly given. All are deviously contrived by establishment schemers possessing the ways and means to fool the masses into acceptance of the lie. There are no exceptions, as innumerable false flag episodes repeatedly used as triggers readily confirm. So, what is it that prompts a rational human being to sign up for a military service founded entirely upon demonstrable lies? Well, Hollywood acts as a recruitment cheerleader-in-chief, but believing their transparent propaganda becomes ever more tenuous in the tragic wake of returning veterans coming to their senses all too late. The catastrophic suicide rate of these devastated lives now far surpasses the actual numbers of combat casualties. Jingoistic phrases like "our glorious dead" are spouted by non-combatants at remembrance services, but seldom issue from war veterans themselves. It's unlikely you'll ever hear the term glory used in any context pertaining to war from anyone exposed to its obscene reality. But there's no shortage of glittering adjectives carefully wordcrafted to sucker in the gullible who, in the light of all the above, have no excuse for not discerning the vicious hoax. You often hear the expression, "they heroically gave their lives," which is misleading because war dead have their lives savagely ripped from them via the violent mass murder of combat. Lives are not freely given, but in actual fact are brutally taken. Why is it that the "lest we forget" mindset forever avoids examining the easily uncovered deceptions triggering the conflict? I emphasize that this commentary in no way detracts from those slain in war, but rather seeks to highlight the criminally false premise that puts them in harm's way in the first place. War remembrance services divert attention from examining the effortlessly proven lies inflicting the carnage. Perhaps if every war memorial denounced in stone the lies that provoked the senseless slaughter, potential recruits might think twice. Again, this infers no disrespect, but rather challenges the perverted mindset that knowingly facilitates endless butchery under false pretense. The Hollywood cliche for king and country makes cruel mockery of those who had lives torn apart or brutally obliterated on the strength of yet another despicable lie. No human being has the right to compel another to maim, to take life, or impose corporate oppression upon others. But these crimes and countless more are routinely inflicted as a direct consequence of groups and individuals voluntarily giving up their sovereign free will to the criminal control of malicious warmongers and satanic mass murderers. This carnage can only continue with the willing participation of those going against humanity by mindlessly obeying criminal directions issued from a source of unspeakable evil. Thank you for watching.